Hello, everyone, and welcome to worship as we gather for the resurrection of our Lord. A few brief announcements. First, for communion today, all Christians are welcome to receive communion at St. John's. When it's your turn, you'll come down the center aisle. You'll take the host from me and the wine from the assisting minister, and then give your cup to the acolyte who will be holding a tray. Gluten-free hosts are available. And also, I wanted to let you know that our spring food drive starts this weekend to support the North Hills Food Bank. If you are able, please take a blue bag from the chapel to help support the food drive. God provides more than enough for everyone, but it's really a matter about improving those systems of distribution. So please do your part to help. Let us prepare our hearts for worship. Will the children please come forward? We have children today? Come on up. Get myself organized. Hello. Hi, everybody. What looks different in our sanctuary today? There's flowers. What else? Do you see anything else that's different? What about that? Is that different? Of a Paschal candle. That's lit at Easter, for the Easter season. Today is a day of celebration. What are we celebrating today? Easter. What do we celebrate on Easter? Yes, Brooklyn? What's that? That's right. God raised Jesus from the dead. Today we'll hear the story of the empty tomb and how God raised Jesus from the dead. And because of what God did in Jesus, we don't have to worry about death, right? Because we get to live forever with God. Now, that makes us so happy. And in the church, when we feel really happy, there's a special word that we like to say. And if you remember, we put that word away in this box on the last Sunday after Epiphany. Does anyone remember what that special word is? Mm-hmm. Hallelujah. We're going to say and sing that word a lot today. So every time we say or sing it, you can shake that hallelujah stick high in the air. And that's how we'll celebrate. So I think it's about time, since we're going to use that word a lot, that we let our hallelujahs out, don't you? Okay, so let's let them out, and you can help me. And we can say it real loud. Hallelujah! Christ is risen. Christ is risen indeed. Hallelujah. Shake them. Yes. Okay, yes. Now let's go over to the font. You can help me with the Thanksgiving for baptism. Drop one. Okay, let's go over here. Now when I say hallelujah, remember to shake that. Here, you can all just gather around. Yeah. Everybody, please stand. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, the wellspring of grace, our Easter and our joy. Amen. Look, here is water. You can put your hand in it. Here is water. Life. Hallelujah. Immersed in the promises of baptism. Let us give thanks for what God has done for us. We give you thanks, O God, for in the beginning your voice thundered over the deep and water became the essence of life. Adam and Eve beheld Eden's verdant rivers. The ark carried your creation through the flood into a new day. Miriam led the dancing as your people passed through the sea into freedom's land. And a desert pool, the Ethiopian official entered your boundless baptismal life. Look, here is water. Here is the water of life. Hallelujah. At the river, your beloved son was baptized by John and anointed with the Holy Spirit. By the baptism of Jesus' death and resurrection, you opened the floodgates of your reconciling love, freeing us to live as Easter people. We rejoice with glad hearts, giving all honor and praise to you through the risen Christ, our source of living water, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen. Look, here is water. Here is our water of life. Hallelujah. Now, if the kids would like to participate in the procession, they're welcome to come with me. We can all process. It's up to you. Follow me if you want to process. grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Let us pray. O God, you gave your Son to suffer death on the cross for our redemption, and by his glorious resurrection, you delivered us from the power of death. Make us die every day to sin, that we may live with him forever in the joy of the resurrection. Through your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
The first reading is from the 10th chapter of Acts. Peter began to speak to the people. I truly understand that God shows no partiality, but in every nation, anyone who fears him and does what is right is acceptable to him. You know the message he sent to the people of Israel, preaching peace by Jesus Christ. He is Lord of all. That message spread throughout Judea, beginning in Galilee after the baptism that John announced, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and with power, how he went about doing good and healing all who were oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. We are witnesses to all that he did, both in Judea and in Jerusalem. They put him to death by hanging him on a tree. But God raised him on the third day and allowed him to appear, not to all the people, but to us who were chosen by God as witnesses, and who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. He commanded us to preach to the people and to testify that he is the one ordained by God as judge of the living and the dead. All the prophets testify about him, that everyone who believes in him receives forgiveness of sins through his name. The word of the Lord. We will read portions of Psalm 118 responsively. Give thanks to the Lord, for the Lord is good.
God's mercy endures forever.
Let Israel now declare,
God's mercy endures forever.
The Lord is my strength and my song. Shouts of rejoicing and salvation echo in the tents of the righteous. The right hand of the Lord is exalted.
The right hand of the Lord has fallen.
I shall not die, but live.
And declare the works of the Lord.
The Lord indeed punished me sorely.
With my hand he hurt his head.
Open for me the gates of righteousness.
I will enter and give thanks to the Lord.
This is the gate of the Lord. I give thanks to you, for you have answered me.
You have come by salvation.
The stone that the builders rejected
has become the
cornerstone. By the Lord has this been done.
It is marvelous in our eyes.
This is the day that the Lord has made. The second reading is from the 15th chapter of 1 Corinthians. Now I would remind you, brothers and sisters, of the good news that I proclaimed to you, which you in turn received, in which also you stand, through which also you are being saved, if you hold firmly to the message that I proclaimed to you, unless you have come to believe in vain. For I handed on to you, as of first importance, what I in turn had received, that Christ died for our sins in accordance with the Scriptures, and that he was buried, and that he was raised on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures, and that he appeared to Cephas, then to the 12. Then he appeared to more than 500 brothers and sisters at one time, most of whom are still alive, though some have died. Then he appeared to James, then to all the apostles. Last of all, as to one untimely born, he appeared also to me. For I am the least of the apostles, unfit to be called an apostle, because I persecuted the church of God. But by the grace of God, I am what I am, and his grace toward me has not been in vain. On the contrary, I worked harder than any of them, though it was not I, but the grace of God that is with me. Whether then it was I or they, so we proclaim, and so you have come to believe. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. The Holy Gospel according to St. Mark, the 16th chapter. When the Sabbath was over, Mary Magdalene and Mary, the mother of James, and Salome bought spices so that they might go and anoint him. And very early on the first day of the week, when the sun had risen, they went to the tomb. They had been saying to one another, "Who will roll away the stone for us from the entrance to the tomb?" When they looked up, they saw that the stone, which was very large, had already been rolled back. As they entered the tomb, they saw a young man dressed in a white robe sitting on the right side, and they were alarmed. But he said to them, "Do not be alarmed. You are looking for Jesus of Nazareth, who was crucified. He has been raised. He is not here. Look, there is the place they laid him. But go tell his disciples and Peter that he is going ahead of you to Galilee. There you will see him, just as he told you." So they went out and fled from the tomb, for terror and amazement had seized them, and they said nothing to anyone, for they were afraid. The Gospel of the Lord.
Thank you.
seated. The other night, I was scrolling through channels on the TV and Still Magnolias was playing. For those of you who have not seen the movie, Still Magnolias follows the lives of six women who share their joys and sorrows, big and small, in a small Louisiana town. The film is adapted from the play of the same title by Robert Harling. It is based on the true story of his sister's death by complications from diabetes. In one scene, the women are gathered around a grave. The men have all left. The mother of the deceased shares with her friends about the night her daughter died in the hospital. She tearfully describes how they turned off the machines when they realized there was no hope. "I just sat there," she says. "I just held my daughter's hand. There was no noise, no tremble, just peace." This image of the women gathered around the grave reminded me of the three women in today's gospel lesson. St. Mark tells us that Mary Magdalene, Mary the mother of James, and Salome were present at Jesus' crucifixion. After the men fled, they remained. They had followed Jesus and served him from the earliest days of his ministry in Galilee. Now they stood watch through those dread hours, listening to his cries of agony on the cross, their hearts breaking in grief and love for their Lord and teacher. They stood among the crowd that mocked him and screamed for his death until the moment the Roman soldier thrust his spear in Jesus' side and declared him dead. And then there was no noise, no tremble, and nothing more for the women to do but watch, pray, and grieve. What a terrible trauma they experienced that day, witnessing the one whom they loved and trusted above all others die such a humiliating and violent death. Mary Magdalene and Mary, the mother of James, watched as Joseph of Arimathea sealed Jesus' body inside the tomb with a giant stone. It was around 6 p.m. on a Friday, just before the start of the Sabbath. As their final gift to him, they wanted to complete the Jewish burial rites by anointing his body. It was customary for women to undertake this duty. But being observant Jews, they had to wait until the Sabbath ended on Saturday evening. Imagine the sorrow of these women as they walked home, having only one another for support in their confusion and grief. Their sole comfort was knowing they were not alone. And what must that Saturday have been like, believing that their friend and teacher was in the grave? Early that Sunday morning, the first day of the week, they gathered when it was still dark and made their way to the tomb, carrying spices to anoint the body. Along the way, they worried about who would roll the stone away for them from the entrance to the tomb. They sound a lot like us, don't they? Worrying about things that haven't happened yet, that may never happen. Worry is part of human nature. Our brains are hardwired to continually imagine all the eventualities that will meet our needs and the obstacles that could get in our way. Because of our fallen nature, our inclination is to worry instead of trusting God. The women reached the tomb just as the sun rose and were shocked to see that the stone had already been rolled back. "Someone much stronger than we are has already been here," they must have said to one another. Upon entering the tomb, they saw a young man dressed in a white robe and were alarmed. St. Mark does not say he is an angel, but he certainly speaks like one. "Don't be alarmed," he says. Throughout the Bible, angels greet people with the words, "Do not be afraid," as if they realize how startling their appearance can be in their dazzling white robes. Angels are very self-aware. You were looking for Jesus of Nazareth, who was crucified, he says. He has been raised. He is not here. Look, there is the place they laid him. The women are stunned. They haven't even had a chance to process his death, and now they are told that Jesus lives. On their walk to the tomb that morning, they only expected one possibility. They came expecting to anoint the body of their Lord and teacher, to serve him one final time. Upon entering the tomb, they did not realize there was hope, and suddenly everything changed. The world became a different place. The future had broken through into the present reality and shifted everything around. What was previously impossible was now possible. Giant rocks had been moved. God had raised Jesus from the dead. Jesus had triumphed over sin, death, and the devil. What a roller coaster of emotions these women must have experienced. From deep sorrow just minutes before to now overwhelming joy. The angel says, go and tell his disciples and Peter, a particular word of comfort for Peter, who denied Jesus, that Jesus is going ahead of you to Galilee, and you will see him there just as he told you. But instead of going out and sharing the good news, the women ran out of there, terrified and amazed, and did not tell a soul, at least not for a while. We are not told how their story ends, but we know that it did not end in that moment of terror and amazement. Our story doesn't end there either. These women went into the tomb expecting death and instead found new life in the risen Christ. When we think about the resurrection story, we most often think about it in terms of what happens after we die. But it is just as much about God's power in Christ to change us amid our circumstances here and now. God has the power to bring amazing things out of our most difficult moments in life, turning our sorrow into joy. With God, nothing is impossible. The ending of St. Mark's Gospel seems abrupt. Biblical scholars have debated whether the original ending may have been lost. Two attempts to complete the story of Jesus are included in the final verses of Mark. St. Mark is not thought to be the author of these. The women must have told someone eventually, because the story got out. It's why we're all sitting here today. Joined to Christ in his death and resurrection through baptism, we are part of that story of the inbreaking reign of God. We now share in new life because of God's boundless love for us. When we are changed by the good news of the risen Christ, how can we keep it to ourselves? How has this story changed you? And how have you been changed by Christ continuing to appear, coming to us in the bread and the wine, coming to us in water and in the faces of those around us? Christ is present with us, coming to us again and again, forgiving us, nourishing us, and uniting us with God and one another. You have been told to go and tell. What will you do? Will you be quiet? Or will you tell the story? Easter is a glimpse of what lies ahead for the world. Hope abounds in the living Christ. Go and share the good news. Alleluia, Christ is risen. Christ is risen indeed. Alleluia, alleluia, amen.
With the whole church, let us confess our faith. We believe in one God,
the Father and the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and became truly human. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, and is spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Rejoicing that Jesus is risen and love has triumphed over fear, let us pray for the church, the world, and all those in need of good news. Holy God, we pray for the body of Christ, the church. Where the church is persecuted, protect it. Where the church is privileged, grant it humility. Where the church is fractured, heal it. Guide us all to embody Christ's love in the world. God of grace, life-giving God, we pray for the earth, your good creation. Join our prayers with branches lifted in praise and roaring waters of new life, that together we may proclaim Easter hope. God of grace,
hear our prayer.
Merciful God, we pray for all peoples and nations. Free oppressed communities from occupation, exploitation, and abuse. Teach leaders your way of justice. Empower peacemakers and all who work to end violence and strife. God of grace,
hear our prayer.
Liberating God, we pray for people everywhere who long for good news. Roll away the stones that keep people from living with dignity and wholeness. Breathe new life and hope into people struggling to make it through each day. God of grace,
receive our prayer.
Loving God, we pray for this community of faith, St. John's Lutheran Church of Perrysville. And we especially pray for Evan, Sally, Sarah, Dave, Sam, Carol, Warren, Levi, Judy, Helen, Allison, those we name in our hearts before you at this time, and for your spirit in our midst. Feed us at your Easter table and fill us with your wisdom that we may serve and care for others. God of grace,
hear our prayer.
Eternal God, we remember those who have gone before us in death. Renew our trust in your promises that we may live with joyful courage and compassion. God of grace,
hear our prayer.
Into your hands, most merciful God, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your abiding love through Jesus Christ, our resurrected and living Lord. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
The peace of Christ be with you always.
And also with you.
Let us share in the peace of Christ. God's peace.
Let us pray. Risen One, you call us to believe and bear fruit.
May the gifts that we offer here be signs of your abiding love. Form us to be your witnesses in the world. Through Jesus Christ, our true vine. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and merciful God, for the glorious resurrection of our Savior, Jesus Christ, the true Paschal Lamb, who gave himself to take away our sin, who in dying has destroyed death, and in rising has brought us to eternal life. And so, with Mary Magdalene and Peter and all the witnesses of the resurrection, with earth and sea and all their creatures, and with angels and archangels, cherubim and seraphim, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. The day that in joy and delight we join with all the angels of heaven and all the creatures on earth to sing our praise and thanksgiving to you, O holy and mighty and glorious God, for Christ is risen.
Christ is risen indeed.
This is the day that you gave light to the earth. This is the day that you saved the Israelites through the sea, and with your pillar of fire led them to freedom. Now every night is as bright as day, and that light is Christ.
Thanks be to God.
This is the day that you broke the chains of death. This is the day that, marrying heaven to earth, you washed away sin, rescued us from evil, and brought us your peace. The Lamb who was slain has begun to reign. For Christ is risen.
Christ is risen indeed.
On the night in which he died, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread and gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Let us proclaim the mystery of faith.
Christ has died.
Christ has risen. Christ will come again. On this day, send us the power of your Holy Spirit. Revive us with the body and blood of our risen Savior. Illumine our lives with your presence and shine your morning star over the whole human race, for that light is Christ. Thanks be to God. Almighty and glorious God, radiant Father, victorious Son, and shining Spirit, we bless your salvation, we sing of your mercy, and we praise your victory through all time and space. For Christ is risen.
Christ is risen indeed.
Amen and amen.
Amen.
Amen and amen. gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, let us pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Christ is made known to us in the breaking of the bread. Come and eat at God's table. Amen. Jesus Christ, strengthen and preserve you in eternal life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Shepherding God, you have prepared a table before us and nourished us with your love. Send us forth from this banquet to proclaim your goodness and share the abundant mercy of Jesus, our Redeemer and friend.
Amen.
Alleluia, Christ is risen.
Christ is risen indeed.
Alleluia. The God of resurrection power, the Christ of unending joy, and the Spirit of Easter hope, bless you now and always.